Hello, good evening, 10th of April 2018. I have to think before I say 2018, you know. Anyway, so what it is that I had this iPhone SE came for no backlight. This was the initial problem. I'm going to go through what I've done on this. This was the initial problem. What happened here that if you have a look here, zoom in here, it had a blown fuse and it's also like pads been burnt. See under the cable, this was this is iPhone SE. Let me start it from the beginning actually. So these three pins here, 1, 2, and 3, they are for the backlight. So what we had a reading here, here, and not here, because this was going to this fuse here, which is missing, and was bulb of, so you know, it was a blob of the burnt fuse plus solder. So that pad come off from both side. Okay, so what I did, I'm gonna show you in ZXW. What I did, I traced it on ZXW because this was the pin, is pin 17, PPLCM backlight anode connection that was going to this filter, and then from here it goes to, we see that going on this test point 22, and the other side of the filter goes to the back side of the phone where we have U4020 and goes diode and cap and diode again. So what I did, I took a wire from this cap 4023 and I did throw a wire from here all the way up to this test point 22, and I put a filter here, yeah, and then throw a wire, the wire which was connected to this cap 4023 that I connected to the filter. So this is what I've done here. If you see under the microscope cam, okay, let me fix the view. Yeah, so this is what I did. I put a shield on, so I just thought I'm gonna make a video, because I'm gonna make another video of iPhone 5s. I have came for no charging, came for CIC. This is what I did. I put a filter, if you see that, on this test point one side, and the other side I connected this cable. So the cable connected all the way going other side here under the shield. Yeah, this is what I did. So I'm just gonna clean it. I'm gonna check it. Display. How does it respond? I've tested it without a filter. Then I thought I'm gonna put a filter in case anything happened, because what caused at first time to blow this filter could cause it again. We don't know. So we don't know. Okay, so how does it go? This is how it is. Yeah, I'm gonna put this sticker back on here. It's burnt this side, so I'm just gonna just remove it from here. Actually cut it in this region. I'm just gonna keep your flex safe. Yep, so let's put it in and check what it does. Got a busy day today. Already made a video of iPhone 6s, came for TriStar, also came for backlight. Also, there was another one of iPhone 7. Came for boot loop, that was fixed here. One came from eBay, boot loop, that was fixed. Got a problem with the front cam. It was not activated, so it's been activated. Somebody messed up the screen previously. So we're gonna check too what's happening with that. Maybe we just gonna replace the flex on that and it's gonna be okay. Okay, so this one came for no backlight. They've changed the screen and most probably the battery was connected when they were working on it and they've blown the anode filter as usual. Oh, it's 26 past 8 actually, and I'm gonna finish a few jobs and then I go home. Check that. Yes, so this is repaired. Came for backlight, blown fuse, missing parts to throw a wire from the other side. And fix that. So another successful repair of backlight. Yep, the phone came on, got a problem, the code on, don't have a code. So I'm gonna leave this for my colleague to do it. And I'm gonna go ahead with the 5S, came as TriStar failure. So let's check that. What we're checking here is, I'm gonna check the voltage. And for that, I am connecting the charging flex. Then I will connect the charger and let's check the reading meter. Nothing, nothing, and nothing. Anything on board? Must be something on this side of the board. Yep, and the board is fine. Okay, so yes, classic example of TriStar failure on this. Okay, so let's check. Back here, that goes here. I'm gonna remove this antenna cable, antenna cable. I remove the shield. Yep, so you know what I'm gonna do one day, I'm gonna show you the pile of the phones around me. Wow.
one of the iPhone 7 came in 6S Plus. I might check that too. It's called a shortage problem, so I'm gonna check that. What is causing it, that shortage? Okay. Come on, dude. Done, removed. Right, okay, so shield's been removed. Now we gonna go for TriStar 1610A1, yeah. Okay, let me adjust the cam first, because if you see it, then I can't see it, so let's adjust it. Yeah. 1610A1. Had iPhone 7 came a few days back and made a video of it. I'm gonna post that too. It came as no power, not connect, not charging at all. I mean, was not showing any life, not connecting computer, no sign on my USB charger. That was a classic example of TriStar, because it was coming on with the with the charged battery. Come on. Okay, so this is off. RC is off, pad's been cleaned, let it cool down a bit. Let's find a TriStar in the meantime. We got so many of these TriStars. Oh, 1610A1 is out. Not wearing gloves because I was about to leave home. Then I thought I'm gonna make some more video. Been a very good day today so far. Success in most of the repairs. I have one BlackBerry Key One, I think it's called Key One, Came for not charging. Guy said it's just a charging block. Physically it looks fine. Further tests revealed that it was nothing to do with the charging connector. Type C. But it's something to do with one of the ICs back of the charging flux. Charging connector. I assume there's something to do with the charging, because it's heating up a lot and it's burnt. And it's burnt the plastic thing which was covering that IC. Wait, you can't see, can you? Okay, so the IC is gonna dance. Love it. There you go, it's done. Dusted. Boop. I might finish this video, or I might go for a 6 came for charging block. Yeah, so yeah, this is the one. Okay, here. So might go and change that. What I do, I don't take this off, just take it off with these things on. Let me just check. What is it? Oops. Okay. Yeah, so it's broken. Yeah, it's broken. So then that would be because it's not charging, because it's broken from the side, this edge. So might change it. It will fix it, definitely. So this one, let's check that. Okay, before I close it, I'm gonna check if we got voltage. On meter. Oops, say warning. Okay, here it goes here, and this goes here. Nothing or anything. Yeah, so we got a voltage, we got restored the voltage, 4.32. so I would say this is fixed, and I put the shield back on, and I think I will call it a day and night, finish it, go home and play cricket with my daughters. They love to play. inside the home. I mean, she's just 8 and one of them is 6. We play cricket inside the house. Wonderful room. It's kind of living room, yeah, if you want to call it. TV lounge. We don't like hit the ball very hard. I mean, just practicing that how to play a cricket. And my young Lisa, she's 6, so she loves to. She wants to be a cricketer. Hey. She like demanded me. She requested me, and she demanded, "Can we come early today so we can play cricket?" They're off from the school, so I go early and play some cricket. Usually, you will see my videos. I'm wearing the blue gloves. Still have it around me. I don't feel like wearing it. I mean, lazy. Shield is on. We're going back to put the antenna cable. It's hot. Come on. Wow, stubborn one. So great. Put the sticker back where we're supposed to be. Put that sticker back. Okay. Just gonna connect the LCD touch and leave it on charge. See what it does. Can you see that? Can you see anything at all on the computer? Oh yeah, you can see that here. Wait. Hey, it's gone. Yeah. That's charging sign anyway. So I'm gonna leave it here, let it charge. And let's go for this Samsung dude. Oh, do I have the charging block? I'm gonna take it off. Anyway, I'm gonna take it off. How do I do that? I have this shield from some phone, I don't know which one. So that goes underneath here. I can actually use something else too, but I used to use this bit. Yeah. It's better to use this one.
No. Not this one. Let me check. I have some more shield somewhere. Yes, this one. Okay. This one here. And well, everybody have their own way to do this. I like to do it this way. Cover it. I'm going to cover the battery. Okay, so that's charging there. Let's get rid of this. Broken charger. How do I do this? Watch carefully. One, two, three, four. That's it, it's off. It always does not come out when I count up to four. It's just whenever it's soft enough, it just comes off. Secret. Okay, what I'm looking for, my... Oh, damn. Did I drop it? Okay, I'm looking for... Oh, hey, found it. Okay. I was looking for my Vic. It was just here somewhere, hiding for me. Fiverr is charging. SE backlight fixed. This. See that? Hey. Okay, need a bit of flux to clean one hole. Just the one hole is left. This one. Yeah, so one of the video earlier I was making fixing this type C charging connector on A350. It had a missing prints all over, so out of 18, there were 13 of them were missing, and then we also found out that 4 of them was going to the one point, so I put them together and fixed the 9, so a total 10 pins there to throw a wire. So when I was fixing that, I was thinking about the doctors, surgeons, those who was working with the human body. Admire it a lot, their work. Nothing compared to ours. We're still working with electronics. I mean, what worse you can do, you can kill the device. So what are you gonna do if you kill the device? You can buy another one and give it to the customer. That could be a worst case. Right, so we have cleaned this. But if you're working with the human body,
human. Of course, you don't want to kill it. Just gonna leave. Chalte. Let me fix one. Let me fix one of the device. No. I'm just making one more video, then we'll go. Okay, let's check the charging flex. Charging block. Samsung. Wait. Not this one. Oh, recently I'm getting these Amazon tabs coming for charging block. The way I fix it, I'll make a video of it. Because the charging block of those Amazons, I think they're like very expensive. £9? I don't know. I'm just saying that. I think it's expensive. Is that the right one? Hey, found it. Okay, so we've done this, so we don't need all this protection now. You can take it off, put it back where it's supposed to be. You can even remove this. So, yay, look at this, what happened. 5S is booting up. So, ooh. Wow. That was not a good sign. Red screen. Whoa. PMIC, charging IC. That is entirely not a good sign. The red screen. Why is red screen? 1610A1. Let me check this cable off. That is error 4013. That is error 4013. If that is coming on red screen, let's check that. Anyway. Oh, I might check that too. It could be something else. You never know. No, it's something different. It's doing something different. Okay, let's fix this one. Leave 5S some other time, because I'm gonna go. What a shame it is. Error, red screen. Red screen 5S is usually when you have a problem with the NAND. We haven't worked anything on the NAND on this. But it had a low reading of a 3 red screen. Wow, bad. Not a good news. Okay, this is it. Fixed. Samsung, I think it's S6, G920F. Okay, all right, let's check the, how does it look like? Let's clean a bit more. Connect the board and see what it is it do. To be honest, I'm not in the habit to close these phones, just to work on these. Because my colleague, they open it for me, they test it, and I do the operation on this one. Gotta make sure what happened. It was supposed to be tested before we work on it. But anyway, so this is new charging block is on. Let's see what it does. Yay! We got charging sign and charging 1%, so we fixed that. 2%, wow, that's going good. Anyway, so I'm gonna finish this video here. It's 9 o'clock almost, and then we're gonna check tomorrow this 5S what happening with this. Well, actually, let me just quickly check this, what is causing it, what could be. Is it long screw damage anywhere? Doesn't look like it. Usually it's none failure. None dicey. Okay, we restore the voltage. Okay, let's check that one more time. With just the battery. Not a charger. See what it does. This is 3%. So this is going good. Got a problem with 5S. Came for low reading voltage repair, but red screen. Oh, that is bad. Anyway, I'm gonna check that. So this is it. I'm gonna finish this video here. This is fixed. Should be coming on too. Yep, that's 6. I'm still like not happy with this, whatever happening with this 5S. Oh, this was it was the last thing I was repairing. I was supposed to come up with this. Look, only thing is a bit bent. This NAND is here. It worked here. Anyway, so we're gonna check that too. This one is fixed. I'm gonna finish this video here. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe our channel and keep watching our videos.
leave some comments. If you have any services to buy, please buy on the website. Check out our YouTube channel, check out our website, check out our Facebook page. Do visit our shop. That's gonna be, and this is it. So I'm gonna finish the video, stop recording. Take care, bye bye, good evening.